Yesterday, I was talking about the Joe Biden problem. Yes, Uncle Joe's got a problem. And it's a problem that he's had for decades. Except times have changed. I guess it used to be somewhat okay for, a guy to be touchy-feely. If it wasn't okay, women just... Or people. It's not only women that Joe Biden does this to, by the way. He does it to people. He's a touchy-feely kind of guy. And I'm not alleging there's anything sexual in it. I never said there was. I just said it's kind of creepy behavior, especially since it has been brought out before. It has been pointed out before. I mentioned yesterday, and I posted on the on social media, a bit from The Daily Show from 2015 with Jon Stewart and Samantha Bee about The Audacity of Grope was the name of the segment. This has been something that has been talked about for ages, but nobody ever did anything about it, probably because there's nothing sexual about it. But it makes people, especially women and especially young girls, uncomfortable. Now, the fact that Joe Biden, I think, exhibits behavior that's unfortunate, that's kind of creepy, stands on its own. It has nothing to do with Donald Trump. The fact of the matter is, I can criticize Joe Biden or anybody else without having any bearing on the piece of shit that Donald Trump is. So you should see the vitriol aimed at me on Facebook because I posted a funny picture. It was Joe, you know, massaging the shoulders of Lady Liberty. And people were like, you need to remove this post immediately. Well, I don't feel that way. But I guess I need to clarify how I feel about Donald Trump. Again, how I feel about Donald Trump has nothing to do with Joe Biden. Donald Trump is the epitome of the despicable excuse for a human being. You want more? He's a racist and a bigot. He's transphobic and no friend to the LGBTQ community. He's a pathological liar and a manipulator. He's a con man of the nth degree, a classic narcissist, and a bully with a complete lack of morality who thinks that the rules don't apply to him. He lacks the empathy gene. He's a gaslighter. He'll never admit a mistake. Instead, he blames everyone else for his failures. He's a sexual abuser with over 16 current accusations of sexual misconduct against him. He's a dictator wannabe who idolizes the world's worst authoritarian figures. He's a danger not only to our democracy, but to our planet. We must do everything possible to defeat him in 2020, even amidst legitimate concerns that he will not voluntarily leave the White House. It's all the more important to make sure the Democrats nominate a viable candidate to defeat him. So I've been taking a lot of slings and arrows for daring to criticize Joe Biden. I believe he's the wrong candidate to take on Trump. But criticizing Joe Biden doesn't lessen my disgust for Donald Trump. Donald Trump is a pig. He's the laughingstock of the world, and I would laugh at him too if it weren't so deadly serious. The guy is a danger to everything and everything, everyone and everything and everything we hold dear. Yes, would I vote for Joe Biden if he was the nominee? Of course I would. That's not even a question. It's not one or the other. Donald Trump is a freak of nature. Donald Trump somehow got the idiots in this country to vote for him. He's a pig. Everything about him is vile. Okay, I still retain my right to criticize somebody who wants to be the Democratic nominee without having to say, but Donald Trump is worse. It goes without saying. Donald Trump is, to quote Keith Olbermann, the worst person in the world. I shouldn't have to qualify it. I can criticize anybody without it impinging on how I feel about Donald Trump. Donald Trump should not be anywhere near that White House, let alone residing in it, let alone holding office hours in the Oval Office. Not that he does. He does the executive time thing in the residence, but you know what I'm talking about. He is a sycophant. He is a sick person who needs to be removed from office. Period. Full stop. End of sentence. But this is also a democracy and we're in primary season. And yes, I will tout Bernie Sanders and I'll also criticize him. Guess what? Bernie Sanders needs to release his fucking tax returns already. He said soon, a while ago, he needs to just fucking do it. All right? So yes, I like Bernie Sanders. Right now, he's my number one choice, with Elizabeth Warren a close second. And you know what? When I see things that bother me about the other candidates, I will voice my concerns because I will not blindly follow any political party. And yes, although I don't really want to say it, because I think it gives the Democratic Party impetus to cheat the way they did last time and try to install their chosen candidate, as the nominee, that's not democracy. This is primary season. I will say, I think Bernie Sanders and Elizabeth Warren are my numbers one and two. I think Joe Biden shouldn't run. I think he's an anachronism at this point. And you'll notice I don't mind Bernie's age because Bernie appeals to the young people. Joe Biden doesn't. He's from a bygone era. He needs to just go home. I like Joe Biden personally. I think he's probably a nice guy. But and exactly, John Doe said, yeah, I was kind of angry with what you said about another Democrat, but this is the time to go through every candidate's weaknesses, not in the main election. This is when we fall in love and we tout our choices and we say, you know, maybe that guy's not so great. Pete Buttigieg, I know a lot of people are high on him, but maybe you haven't done your homework yet. Let me recommend to you an article in Current Affairs magazine. Just go to Current Affairs, I think it's .com. Not .com, .org, but probably .com. And Nathan, I think is Henderson is his name. I invited him back on the show. I haven't heard back from him yet. But he wrote a long piece about Pete Buttigieg. He read Pete Buttigieg's book. And there were a few things that he flagged as kind of, you know, disturbing. Basically, the way Pete Buttigieg sort of sides with the establishment politicos over activists and protesters. I'm not going to paraphrase it because it's a long article and I think it's worth a read. I will link to it from today's blog at NicoleSandler.com. And yes, as Lambsbread just said in the YouTube chat room, I bet Anita Hill doesn't think Joe Biden's a nice guy. You're right. There's a lot of red flags there for me. And it is my right to voice my opinions. And I'll continue doing so. And for people who are yelling at me to take down a funny meme that, again, it was a picture of Joe Biden, you know, rubbing on the shoulders of Lady Liberty. It was funny. I wasn't saying anything other than this is funny. Have a laugh. And yet, oh my God, you should see the comments on my Facebook page. Take this down. You're just rooting for Trump. You're going to let Trump win again. No, I'm not. Again, has nothing to do with Trump. Trump is a vile, despicable piece of shit. Human excrement. Has nothing to do with my feelings about Joe Biden, positive or negative, or any of the other candidates for that matter. So, you know, I do not believe in attacks for the sake of attacking, but I do believe in pointing out questionable errors in judgment and in policy. And sorry, Joe Biden's voting record is as bad as his creepy behavior with people that, you know, invading their personal space. And if you were offended by Donald Trump lurking around Hillary Clinton in that third debate in the last election, you should be as equally creeped out by Joe Biden touching people that he doesn't know. Okay. So